Hi friends, my name is Nandita. I am from Andhra Pradesh.
Now let us discuss about secondary growth. Cells of apical meristem divided, differentiated and developed to form primary tissues. As a result, the plant grows in length. This is called primary growth. By the cavity of secondary, lateral meristem increases in the circumference drift of the plant organs due to the formation of secondary tissues in stellar and extrastellar regions. It is called secondary growth. Normally, secondary growth takes place in roots, stems and dicotyledons, gymnosperms, etc. Due to lack of cambium in monocotyledons, secondary growth is absent. But exceptionally, secondary growth takes place in some monocotyledons such as plum, yucca, dracaena, smilax, agave, coconut, etc. Let us discuss the secondary growth in dicot stem. Secondary growth in stellar region. Secondary growth in stellar region begins earlier than the extrastellar region. Formation of ring of vascular cambium. Let us discuss about formation of ring of vascular cambium. A cambium which is present inside the vascular bundle is called intravascular cambium. This is a type of primary meristem. First of all, cells of medullary rays becomes meristematic to form intravesicular. Formation of rings of vascular cambium. A cambium which is present inside the vascular bundle is called intravesicular cambium. This is a type of primary meristem. First of all, cells of medullary rays become meristematic to form intervesicular cambium, which is secondary lateral meristem. The intravesicular and intervesicular cambium are collectively known as vascular cambium VC. Vascular cambium is formed in the form of a complete ring which is made up of a single layer of cells. In dicot stem, some part of VC is primary and some part of VC is secondary. Two types of cells are found in the ring of this vascular cambium is fusiform initials and ray initials. Fusiform initials are long with pointed ends, while ray initials are spherical, that is oval. Amount of fusiform initials is more in vascular cambium. Now let us discuss about the activity of vascular cambium. The activity of fusiform initials continues periclinal divisions of tangential divisions takes place in fusiform initials. The plane division in periclinal divisions is parallel to longitudinal axis of a cell. Through this type of activity, few cells are formed towards the radius and these cells are differentiated into secondary phloem or bast, and some of these cells are formed towards the central axis and these cells are differentiated into secondary xylem or wood. Normally, more secondary xylem is formed as compared to secondary phloem due to unequal distribution of hormones. By the pressure of secondary phloem, primary phloem is pushed towards the outside and gets crushed. By the pressure of secondary xylem, all the primary tissues such as primary xylem, pith, etc. and old secondary xylem degenerates in the center of the stem. Due to this, central part of the stem becomes woody. This activities keep on going on continued plant throughout the life. The secondary xylem forms in a plant regularly and primary tissues degenerate continuously. This new secondary xylem also degenerates the old secondary xylem. Waste materials are formed in the stem, such as lignin, seborrhein, tannin, resin, gums, due to degeneration of the cells. All these waste materials are filled in the lumen cavity of the tracheids and vessels of secondary xylem. Because of this, wood in the central region of the stem becomes dark colored. It is called hot wood or duramen. The peripheral or outer wood, which looks light in color, is known as sapwood alburnum. As a result of growing of a secondary xylem, the diameter of hot wood increases. Physiologically active wood is sapwood. The main function of sapwood is water conduction. The hardwoods provides maximum mechanical strength to the stem. Conducting of water is not carried by hardwoods because cavities of tracheids and vessels are possibly filled by waste material. The bladder-like in growth of parenchyma cells enter the lumen of vessels and tracheids through pits in their wall. Such bladder-like ingrowth are called as tylosis, and tylosis blocks the conduction of water. In gymnosperm, tylosoids are formed in the place of tylosis. On the basis of amount of parenchyma, the wood is classified into two groups. Manozoic wood. Such type of wood contains more living parenchyma. It is soft and loosey wood. Example, cycas and other gymnosperms. Pycnozoic wood. Such wood contains less amount of living parenchyma. It is hardwood. Such type of wood are found in most of the plants like pinus, mango, epica, tectona, etc. On the basis of presence or absence of vessels, wood is classified again into two categories. One is non-porous softwood wood. The non-porous softwood vessels are absent in such type of wood, examples of gymnosperms. Porous wood. Vessels are present in such type of wood. On the basis of arrangement of vessels, porous wood is divided again into two types. Ring porous wood. The ring porous wood vessels are arranged in the form of a ring in this type of wood. Such wood conducts water more efficiently. Examples, Dalberia in temperate region. Diffused porous wood. A diffused porous wood is a systematical distribution of vessels. A systematical distribution of vessel is found in this type of wood. Example, Azadirachta in tropical region. Important facts. If the hardwood is destroyed in any stem, then there will be no effect on plants. But if the sapwood is destroyed, then the plant will be die because conduction of water will be blocked. Heartwood provides stiffness to the stem. The waste material of heartwood are antiseptic in nature. Heartwood is resistant to bacteria and fungus. Heartwood has power of repelling insects. So it is resistant to termites, and in the rainy season it does not imbibe water. Thus, it is the best quality of the wood. Study of the wood is known as xylotomy. If a wood is exposed freely in air, then decomposition of sapwood takes place rapidly. The position of youngest layer of stem phloem is just outside the vascular cambium. So position of older layer of secondary phloem is just inside the primary phloem. The position of youngest layer of secondary xylem is just inside the vascular cambium. Then the position of older layer of secondary xylem just outside the primary xylem. If the xylem is blocked, then the shoot will be die first. Non-porous wood is also called homozylous wood, and porous wood is also called heterozylous wood. Let us discuss the activity of initial. Periclinal divisions occurs continuously in re-initials of vascular cambium. Some of these cells are formed towards inside and some of these cells are formed towards outside through these divisions. All these cells are made up of parenchyma. Radial lines of cells of parenchyma are formed in the stem. These are called vascular rays and secondary medullary rays. The medullary rays are primary and vascular rays are secondary. Both of them conduct water and food in radial direction. Order of development of vascular rays is in both centripetal and centrifugal manner. Formation of annual rings. Annual rings are formed due to the unequal activity of vascular cambium. The activity of cambium does not remain same. It is changeable in the whole year. Activity of the vascular cambium is affected the physiological and environmental factors. In winter and autumn season, the activity of the cambium is less and the secondary xylem or wood formed is not extended through the vascular cambium. Cells formed during this period are small, thick-walled and have narrow lumens. This is called autumn wood or late wood. The vascular cambium is highly active in spring or summer season and secondary xylem is formed during this period is extensive and cells of secondary xylem are large, thin-walled and have wider lumen. This wood is known as spring wood or early wood. The spring wood is lighter in color and exhibits low density whereas the autumn wood is dark and has higher density. The autumn and spring woods are formed in the forms of rings. The rings of any type of wood is called growth ring. Those two growth rings are formed in one year. A ring of autumn wood and a ring of spring wood are collectively known as annual ring. Thus, an annual ring consists of two rings. The number of annual rings formed in a tree give the idea of the age of the tree. The study of determination of age of the plant by this technique is called dendrochronology. The annual rings are counted from the base of the stem because the basal part has maximum annual rings and the upper part has less. Therefore, counting from the basal region can give the correct idea. Most distinctive annual rings are formed in that region where climatic variations are sharp. More distinct annual rings are formed in temperate plants. Distinct annual rings are not formed in tropical plants. Distinct annual rings are not formed in India except Himalaya regions. Least distinct annual rings are formed in seahorse rings because the climate regions the same throughout the region. More clear, annual rings are found in deciduous plants as compared to evergreen plants. In deserts, the annual rings are less distinct. Annual rings are bands of secondary xylem and xylem rings. Sometimes drought conditions prevail during the middle of growing season, resulting in the formation of more than one annual ring. These are called pedicellate annual rings.